So I'm picking up Lena and Zainab. We're going to LA. We're taking a little road trip, and then we're meeting some special guests there. I'm sure you guys know who it is by now, but I just wanted to say, honestly, I just need a karma at this point. Like, it's not even funny anymore. But anyways, I just wanted to say I'm sorry for not uploading in a while. I have been very busy. I've been moving. I've been working on my second drop, which I should be announcing soon. But since you guys are following me on here, it's gonna be the contrast stitch corsets, but pastels. Like, kind of like my nail color vibes. But yeah, I'm really excited. Also, like, these little necklaces I might sell. I'm planning on selling because they, like, match with the corsets, and I honestly think it's really cute. But I'm only gonna sell one of each just to see how they do. And if they do well, like, who knows, maybe I'll bring them back. But as far as corsets, I did make more sizes this time around. So I'm hoping they do well. But I have, like, a lot of content planned for it. So sorry for kind of ghosting y'all for a bit. I swear I had a reason. But I have been vlogging, like, my processes. I want to say, Airbnb is like the worst company I've ever encountered.
Yeah.
If you guys knew what we had to go through to even get this place to begin with, I think we were talking to Airbnb for like a total of like 20 hours.
Yeah.
Over the span of like a week.
Yeah.
And then now we get to this place. Our check-in was at 4. It's currently 5:26. It's not ready, and like the key was not in the box. And then he was like, there's no, because obviously we have my car, we need to park it, and like parking was included. But then he's like, the person before you lost the gate code or the gate key. And then so Lena's like, where am I supposed to park? And then he's like, well, you could do straight parking. Like, please, what? And then he said another 30 minutes, so like total of an hour of just sitting here waiting. And he's like, I'm not in LA, so I can't give you the
key till 10. I'm gonna go to like every countertop, and I'm gonna like wipe it, make sure there's no dust. And like, yeah, since it took like 1 hour.
Yeah, and they charge like $1 billion cleaning fee, so it better be a spick and span. Every trip we've ever been on, we've had a malfunction with
Airbnb. I don't think there's any trip that you could ever go on and there isn't like a malfunction. Especially if you're dealing with Airbnb. So please,
y'all remember how we were just sitting in the car waiting?
Vibing?
For cleaning. That Airbnb is like literally disgusting.
It literally smelled like smoke.
And there's like,
it smelled like weed actually, sorry, not smoke.
There's like crumbs of weed everywhere. Like there's just stains, like nothing was clean. There's like literally like hairs in the bathtub, like basically like throw up on the rug, like stains on the couch, like the sheets are dirty. There's like, literally like a booger.
The irony of it all is that we were waiting to get in because the guy was supposedly cleaning the place.
For sure sleeping.
And he made us wait 1 hour and 20 minutes, y'all, for like literally nothing. And like then when we complained, he offered us $40. Like, please, what is that gonna do for me?
Yeah. At this point, it's literally God's plan.
And then, because Camille and Toph were gonna meet us here, their flight got,
that's an emergency land.
Yeah, because someone, like, was having a medical emergency, and basically now they're back in Texas, and we are here, and basically we're just stranded, because we don't know where to sleep, so now we're going to Dave's to eat our feelings out.
Pretty much.
So, and like I'm literally like nauseous because of like how gross the place smelled.
Yeah,
Thank you, Airbnb.
And
thank you, Airbnb.
Yeah, I just want to say Airbnb is like the worst company I've ever encountered.
We've had way too many problems with them.
And also the people in LA are the worst drivers I've ever encountered.
And everyone's really rude here.
Yeah.
Yeah, like literally we had the, like, cause the, to get in, it was like through a lobby and there's like a, like, what is that?
It's like a key.
Like, I don't know, I'm a fob, but I don't know.
Yeah, I'm a fob. We're all fobs.
Anyways, like,
to be honest, we're just
like, yeah,
checked out, honestly.
And then
oh yeah, there you go.
Like these two guys, or this white guy, let me specify, looked at us like with all of our stuff and made sure to close the door when, like, clearly we were trying to get in. And then when we were getting out, we had all our stuff once again. And these two guys looked at us and, like, continued to come in and, like, made us wait for them. Like, yeah. Please. Like, people are so rude, honestly.
We literally had our luggage.
Like, please get over yourself. Like, and I don't care how rich you are or whatever. I'm just over it at this point.
At this point, all we have is to be patient. Like, we can't really do much.
Like, honestly, I'm about to sleep in here at this point.
I feel like we're so used to situations like this. Like, we actually do know how to,
like, defeated.
Yeah, it's like defeated. Now we're just waiting for Airbnb to contact us again and hopefully try to, like, resolve it. You know.
Because if not, like, I'm literally head of movement. Like, I don't even know.
We're sleeping, I don't know where.
In the car.
No way. Maybe.
Anyways, I guess we'll catch you in that day.
Hopefully our situation, hopefully days won't disappoint us, and hopefully our situation is resolved next time this recording, next time we open this camera up to record.
So we got Dave's. How was it? First time? First time, Loki?
Yeah.
How was it? At least this did not disappoint us.
I just want y'all to know I'm literally rotting outside of Dave's because Airbnb is like literally thinks I'm a clown and I'm incompetent or something, because it's been like 20 hours at this point and they think I will literally sleep in my car. Like, absolutely not, even though we probably could, but absolutely not. And
that's the tea.
Camilla and Tamim are still like in, I don't even know where, and they probably won't be here for like another 2 hours, so now we're just gonna drive around, I guess.
Hello, y'all.
Hi, guys.
Sorry. I just want y'all to know it is
having a blast.
This is the update.
We are currently at, let me turn the camera on.
We're literally on Westwood Boulevard.
The doors are locked, right?
Yeah,
at a CVS. We wanted to get water, but now we can't even, like, get out of the car.
The tiredness just hit us. It is 11:50 right now. Literally 11:50 at the moment. Camilla and Tamim are like literally in SF at the moment.
I said that usually we've had, I think every trip I've been on with you, Sarah, we've had like a major malfunction happen. Like every, like when we went to London, we had a major malfunction in London. And when we, even when we went from London to Paris, we had a major malfunction on the way.
The entire time you're tired.
We had a major malfunction. When we got to Paris, remember, like, with our luggage, they wouldn't, like, show, it's chaotic. We couldn't store our luggage at the train station.
Oh my.
What?
That guy, like, literally started running at those guys. Please, I'm sorry.
Who was gonna come into this box of a car?
Yeah.
Oh, that one!
If they tried, the car will break them.
It's literally delirious hour. I'm so tired. I'm literally crashing off the, like, two coffees we had today. We're severely dehydrated. Do not smell the best at the moment. Do not look the best at the moment. Do not feel the best at the moment.
Eric? I hope you.
Our host screwed us over, and he does not want a refund. I don't think he processed a refund yet.
I think he's waiting for us to give him the key back.
But honestly, I'm gonna throw his keys away at this point.
I'm literally gonna snap that scanner.
And this is like literally our life.
Okay, it's day two.
We finally, well, kind of figured out our situation. We just ended up staying in a hotel, and then Airbnb's gonna pay for it. And then we're looking for Airbnbs today. And right now, we finally acquired Camilla.
Acquired? Y'all, you don't want to know the stuff that I'm doing.
Who the hell's evil eyeing me? Like, get the hell out.
The amount of, like, trauma I've been through the last.
Yeah. Thought I used to, boys. All right, Alfred's in Beverly Hills. Guys, we came to, I ain't even about to say it because I don't know how to say it, but it basically has like a bunch of Vietnamese stores, and we mainly came for this like jewelry store for Camilla. And then we got, isn't it good?
Oh my god, kind of sweet though.
Cause the condensed milk.
Yeah.
But yeah, we got Viet coffee cause we were like literally about to pass away.
Oh, I put it upside down.
But it's like straight to the brain coffee, which is exactly what I need cause I was like dozing
This craps on vanilla lattes, like,
I just wish there was a way for it to be dairy free.
Taste it.
Cause they use condensed milk.
That guy keeps messaging me.
Jewelry shopping.
At my cousin's store.
I'm not even gonna, can you say the place?
We're gonna go look for, Sara and I wanna get matching something. Keep like your ears up there, babe. I mean, mom. I keep calling my mom babe, dude. Oh my gosh.
But this is the most Viet people I've ever seen. I feel like I'm in a different country.
How about Lonnie, you're in Vietnam?
Also, I got this like jade ring.
So cute.
It's like two-tone.
And we're gonna look for some gold.
Guys, can you tell me how I'm in the backseat of my own car? We got told to drive in my car, which he claims to hate, but he's secretly loving it. We were at Buffalo Toe or whatever. No, that's not it either. For like 20 billion hours.
It's not hours.
Me and five different cameras.
Me and Camilio got these.
You guys, can you just look at them?
We're still dealing with Airbnb, and what time is it?
Right here.
6:37. Looks like another night at Ralph's for us. Came to Grand Central Market. We're eating gourmet PB&J. We both got the red eye.
Wait, you got it toasted?
Yeah. It has like espresso peanut butter.
So good, dude.
And like raspberry jam. We're at Melrose Trading Post, and it's so hot.
Y'all, Sara got
Trading Post. I got these pearl earrings.
Aren't they so cute?
It's like croissant.
And it matches her necklace.
And then these sunglasses look so
cute. We're still going.
I'm like wilding out a bit, but like
I still want to find stuff. Only Sara can pull all these stuff off.
Hey guys, we came to Lakma. Being tourists. Yeah, we got ditched. Double vlog inception.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you cannot see them on here, but.
We're at Alibi Coffee. We got this garlic habanero bagel, honeycomb latte with oats, and then Zainab got, what'd you get?
A cream cold brew.
That looks fire. And then what'd you get? Oat cup.
The best thing here.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Fingers up, piggies up.
I'm gonna cut mine in pieces.
Day three. Our
I just want to say, and who put these people up front?
I just want to say this coffee is busting.
Yeah, that I have to get another one.
I'm literally
one
trying to savor it. And they're,
guys, I
they're
never
so
finished
nice.
My coffee. I never finished my
and
coffee.
And they're so nice
and
there.
It's gone.
And like, because they forgot about my drink and he gave me a free coffee coupon. So best believe I'm getting the same thing again.
And guess what?
World Cup.
Just guess what? Taking it back to Texas.
Did I say you could put your Topo Chico in?
Oh my gosh, Shadju. You guys are annoying. Why did we put the Topo?
I don't know. I don't know.
Let me drive.
This is the real stuff right here.
Okay, Tiafa. You sponsored.
Yeah,
that's
what I like.
No, bro.
What is that?
Okay, guys, carpool karaoke.
Carpool karaoke.
I was like, ew, that guy just spelled like, movie like, in the
no, middle. Like, this
it's
is the
nasty.
Combo. I'm sorry.
I just want you to know I got that whole combo on here.
In my soda. In my soda. Cause everyone is looking at the phone, trying to feel like they